It's not a normal fire anymore. It's cool and can take me anywhere on the fireplace travel network. I guess I just have to think of the symbols that are painted on the plan next to the library fireplace. Owl, worm, rat. Owl, worm, and rat.
Ta-da!
Wow! Wherever the missing library is, I'm inside it now.
What was that?
Hello? What is it?
What does it want here?
My name is Wilbur Weathervane. Who is speaking?
It's scary.
You're scary. I was attacked by books with glasses on.
He's trying to break loose. Help!
He has awakened. What does it want?
I want to read you. who are you?
Who are you?
We are books, so,
That's a mustache.
Yes, books. That is the word.
True.
And you're alive?
That's none of your business.
What happened?
What happened? I found the library and I heard noises. I guess that was probably you.
The book is more powerful than the, thingy.
What's it called again?
Sword?
You know, for writing.
Pen?
Right. The book is mightier than the thingy.
okay. Sure.
Could I perhaps get up?
Would you mind letting me get up? It's pretty uncomfortable here.
Haha, never.
But
thanks.
At some point you'll have to let me get up.
Is that possible?
What?
That we, sooner or later, have to let him get up?
No idea.
The answer to your question is...
Okay. Okay, I'll just lie here for now.
Exactly. Like,
do you live here in the missing library?
So, the missing library's your home?
It, isn't missing.
It was here the whole time.
Where's here?
Well, for the rest of us out there, it wasn't there.
Out there?
You know, in the school.
Shoo? Do you know anything about them?
School, not shoe.
You wear them on your feet.
So you mean your feet thought the thing here had disappeared?
You seem quite confused. What kind of books are you, actually?
I'm not being funny, but you seem to be pretty confused to me.
Confused? Ha! We are, we're books. We know everything.
All right, then. So come on, tell me. What type of books are you?
Yes.
Me? Well, I'm a big, a fee, lost or fee book. Yeah. And my comrade here is, thingy.
Thingy.
I am a, you write words in it and explain them.
A dictionary?
A written word explanation book.
There's something pretty weird here. How about we try and figure out what's going on here? What do you reckon?
You can't trust it.
We don't know what it is.
You figure books would be smart.
It is not a book.
I say we throw it out the window so that its leaves are scattered to the four winds.
I think you're right. It has its own thoughts, and that is not a good thing, I think.
Well, I think you're getting a little bit carried away with yourselves.
Careful!
It's having itself loose. It's coming right for us.
A slow motion?
A monster.
Look, you, I won't hurt you, but something really weird is going on here. And I am not going to let you throw me out the window.
Do you even have a window?
We don't like it. We know it not. It scares us.
Nasty hobbit.
A hobbit? There's stuff to look at. There's the fireplace we came through, all kinds of stuff. Since we're already way over than I thought we would be, I should have just stopped before going through the fireplace, but well, I figured that would be a pretty cruel, what do you call it, spot to leave off. Too much. Yeah. But, yeah. So I guess we'll continue. This will be part two of. Two. Let's look at the fireplace we came through.
The journey through the fire network is anything but comfortable. You get sucked into a vortex, and then there are openings everywhere.
And we went through one of them.
Somehow, I still came out in the right fireplace.
Because we were thinking of the correct symbols.
Unless I find another exit, the fireplace network could be my only way out.
Right.
But to use it, I'm going to need fire.
Oh, oops.
Unless I find
We didn't bring our lighter with us.
I wonder if the books were always alive, or were they brought to life because of this place? And shouldn't books be terribly wise creatures? Why are the ones here so simple-minded?
That's what I was exactly wondering. We can take a book? I'm sure they'll love that.
That's strange. The writing is very pale and fuzzy. It's almost as if... I have to get used to these living books.
Alright, there's a note here. Let's check it out. Oh, bear rug.
A note?
Stuck in its nostril.
This is a spell. I think it's even... Yes! The fire spell! The
Sweet!
The most important spell of all to a mage!
Is it?
I finally have it!
Well, now we can leave this place, but of course, after we've, finished our task here.
The fire spell! Finally! Now I can start a fire anytime, anywhere!
Now we can burn books! Look at the doily.
If it weren't so scary here, the library could be a really nice place. I think it once was. You don't see doilies anywhere else in the school.
Take.
Finely crafted white doily. Useless, but pretty.
Yeah, they're not very useful things, generally speaking. Drawer?
Empty. Everything that might once have been in there seems to be spread across the desk. I need wood for a fireplace, and instead of burning books or a shelf, I'd rather have something that no one seems to use.
A drawer?
Wood is old and very dry. It would burn well.
Well, let's just put it in there for now.
It would be better if the headmaster never finds out about this.
Well, let's not tell him.
Everything is ready for a cozy fire.
What else we had to look at? Desk, more books, wall. Bet you that's a secret wall.
Not sure this desk was meant for students. It might have belonged to the librarian. Looking at the tools, a large part of the work must have been the care and repair of books.
Look on the desk. Oh, we got all kinds of stuff. Ooh. Sheet of paper.
Another book page. I'll take it with me.
This one? Broken book?
Oh. Book is in worse than poor condition.
It's maimed.
Blue has given up the ghost and now several pages are missing. Here's one of the pages. I'll take it with me. If I could repair the book, that might convince the other books that I mean them no harm. I would have to sew the missing pages together and then glue them to the book spine.
Dum-de-doodle-oo.
Huh?
What?
Do you know anything about book repair?
Dum-de-doodle-oo.
Everything.
You have to sew the pages together, right? A few at a time.
Well, we have something to sew with.
The so-called choirs.
And these choirs are then glued to the book?
Correct. For which you need wheat starch paste.
I don't have that.
I don't have any of that.
Alternatively, alchemically manufactured adhesives or some natural products, such as troll snot, can be used.
Ugh.
Troll snot?
Correct. Troll snot forms the basis of many industrial adhesives.
Lovely.
Thank you for this valuable and somewhat disgusting information. Cheers.
Cheers. Oh, wow. Let's look on the desk. I didn't think I looked at everything yet. Jelly glowfish. Oh, I remember them.
Jelly glowfish usually only survive a few years
from the first game.
Perhaps the books fed them so they wouldn't have to live here in total darkness.
Perhaps.
Wouldn't that be terrible? To be locked in a library and not have enough light to read all the wonderful books around you.
It would.
If I could repair the book, that might convince the other books that I mean them no harm. I would have to sew the missing pages together and then glue them to the book spine. I would have to...
Okay. We're gonna do that, but first... Let me look up. What's up? Look up, will ya?
I think the library goes even further up there. One can hardly see anything because it's so dark, and I don't see a ladder or a stairway that would lead up there.
You have to fly.
If the librarian wasn't some sort of monkey, I mean an ape, I don't know how he'd get up there. I thought there weren't very many books in this school. No wonder. They're all here. Depending on what lies beyond the passages, this could easily be the largest magic library in the country.
Yeah, you never know. Yeah, let's look at these books.
The books have all retreated to the shelves. I don't know which ones attacked me. Listen, I won't hurt you. I've been looking for you. You and the library should come back to the school.
Make it go away.
It scares us.
But I won't hurt you. How can I prove that?
Go away.
That's not an answer.
Did you make the library disappear? Do you know how to make it reappear?
It should leave us alone.
Maybe we can help each other. One hand washes the other.
Hey, it wants to wash us, so the last bit of ink will blur.
No, I... talking isn't helping here. I just have to prove to them I'm their friend. Maybe they know how to make a library reappear. Maybe they don't. Whatever. As long as they don't trust me, I won't get a thing out of them.
Right.
Maybe they know whatever.
Look at this wall.
This wall, this arch, it looks like a door belongs here, but there's only a wall. It's almost as if this room was hiding from the world. Or was it forgotten?
Both.
This wall...
Dish wool. Burn the books. Okay.
Archmage Alistair's magic Hello?
How can I help you, Mr. or Mrs. Enter username.
How can I get out of this library?
Can you tell me how to get back out of the library?
Enter and exit rooms through the corresponding openings in the wall region. Should none of these so-called doors be available, try using the smaller openings that do not reach to the ground. See also window.
Slate, you say simple things in a really sophisticated manner. Wow, windbag. Okay, yeah, over and out. The moment, I have no questions.
All right. Here's our thing that we made. Sew the leaves.
I can sew the pages into a choir later, but I still haven't found all of them.
It's the rest is here. Okay. Come on. Seriously? Thank you. Loose pages.
Individual sheets aren't going to get me far here. I have to use a thread to sew all of the pages into a quire.
We need troll snot, but the troll's not here.
If I could repair the book, I would have to sew them.
No snot on the keyring. Well, maybe we have to go. If we need troll snot. Then we have to leave and go get it. And put it on something. Wait.
Ignifaxius ignis feral. I'm slowly getting the hang of this.
Cool.
What did it do?
It summoned the red devourer.
Ah. Now they're really gonna trust me.
I'd like to say that the fire makes this room look a little bit more friendly. The reality is, it casts longer shadows and provides more hiding places for these strange books.
They're really trying to hide now.
That was the last of the fireplace travel powder, but I think it was enough.
That's the last of it? How are we gonna get back? Wait. Oh, is it gonna just stay open? That would be helpful. He's telling me there's enough powder to go back and forth 100 times. That's what he said. I believed him, too. I need some of your snot. I'm sure you have plenty of it. Can you put some snot? Blow your nose on this.
Look here. Isn't it pretty?
Ugly.
That's not true. Got it from my grandmother. It's an heirloom. And, wah, it means a lot to me.
Thank you for showing it to me.
Ha ha! I tricked you. I wanted your snot in the cloth.
Oh, wow! You're so great! Snort!
Thanks for the snot.
I don't... The doily is soaked with viscous, greeny, browny, slimy troll snot. I think there's a few lumps in it, too.
Ugh.
I can well imagine that this stuff makes an excellent glue. It sure has the right consistency, anyway.
I think we're going to become ill. What does he hold his nose when he goes in? Ah. Alright, so how exactly, what is the order in which we do this stuff?
I have the troll snot, which is supposed to stick better than any glue. But I can't glue the pages in individually. First of all, I have to use a needle and a thread to sew all the missing pages together into a quire.
That's what I've been trying to do. Here's my needle and thread, damn you.
I could sew the pages into a quire later, but I still haven't found all of them.
You mean there's more? There's more pages?
I have the troll snot, but I can't glue. I could sew the page.
Maybe one of these? I don't know. Maybe one of the pages are in here.
Maybe they make library reappear. Maybe they don't. Whatever.
Hmm. I'm missing pages.
It's almost as if this room was hiding from the world.
Hmm. I'm missing pages. I need more of the Slenderman's pages.
I hope no one notices.
Got any pages, Mr. Blockhead?
Excuse me, Headmaster Block.
Yes?
About those tasks.
Yes?
I found the library.
I was in the library. It's fine, more or less.
Really? Where is it?
I don't know.
Well, it's not easy to get into. You just need a little bit of magic.
Unfortunately, that is unacceptable. The library is a room like every other room in this building, and it has to live with the fact that staff and students may want to enter it in the conventional manner.
Oh, yeah?
Through the door.
There is no door.
But how?
I do not care how. Get the room back, Professor. And then I can finally return this loose page to where it belongs.
Oh, give me that. Give me that page.
What I wanted to...
Is that note a page from a book?
That note you have there, it looks like a page from a book.
Yes, indeed. It's an incomplete travelogue. The traveler, apparently a researcher, speaks of a country called Laputa.
Laputa?
The arts, sciences, languages, and crafts are revolutionary. Very exciting concepts, but unfortunately, the book is incomplete.
Well, I found the rest of the book.
If you give me the page, I might be able to find the rest of the book for you.
Hmm. Thank you. I'd like the whole story. I'm sure the tale will end well and will serve as a role model for us. Yeah, take it.
Yay. Yay! That fanfare tells me it's the last page that we need.
So, I'll get back to work then.
You do that. After all, you...
Yeah, shut up.
I found all the missing pages from the book.
Yay.
Now these pages need to be sewn together into a quire and then glued into the spine. All right, now I'll sew the seven together. Done! A beautiful new choir for a book.
Cool.
I have sewn the seven lost sheets together to form a choir. Now I have to glue the choir into the damaged book in the library.
I want to read them. I want to read the pages. Okay. Handy step stool.
All right, I'll smear a little troll snot along the spine.
Ugh. Ugh. Echo.
Now I'll carefully glue the choir in.
Echo of disgust.
Done. Good as new. I attempted to rise, but was not able to stir. For, as I happened to lie on my back, I found my arms and legs were strongly fastened on each side to the ground.
Gulliver's Travels?
The same was the case with my very long and thick hair. I likewise felt several slender ligatures across my body, from my armpits to my thighs. I could only look upwards. The sun began to grow hot, and the light offended my eyes.
You and read me?
Well, of course. You are actually one of my favorite books.
Yeah, where are you going, Wilbur?
Read on.
You mean you can...
Oh.
Books cannot read. We have to be read. When no one reads us, our stories fade and we forget who we are.
Is that true?
That is so sad. I would love to help you all, but I've so much to do and I can't possibly read you all.
Reading books is ancient magic. You can travel to foreign places, the past and the future.
What does that mean?
There's always time for a good book.
Book.
Well, okay then. Who wants to go first?
Me! Pick me!
Oh boy.
It was the best of times. It was the worst of times. It was the age of wisdom. It was the age of foolishness.
It was the age of incredulity.
That was great. I'm going to repeat that as soon as possible.
Well, like 2 years later. Right.
Well, how did I do?
Oh. Now we know where the library
how
is.
How long has that gone?
Not long enough.
Ta-da. Go ahead, talk to him.
I don't have...
So now we can just go in, walk into the library. Here's the door.
Wow!
Wow, nice.
It looks like this library has finally returned to life.
Wow. Well, these happy books. Rotten books. What happened here?
Oh, what happened to these books?
A sad story. Their fate was sealed by the leaky roof.
Well, maybe. Maybe I can fix them.
It's too late for that.
Oh.
Correct. That's why we should help them before they're destroyed.
Go back in time?
No, not this.
Oh, I like that color text.
We've already been through all this. The book friend hasn't got time for silliness. Time is irrelevant.
You are irrelevant.
The books are ruined, and there's nothing we can do to change that.
Oh, the books are right. The friends are all rotten and moldy. Even the best bookbinder couldn't save anything here. And I'm not even close to being the best.
I guess we have to go back in time to fix them.
Fire is once again an ordinary fire. I don't know how long I sat in front of it and read. It must have been a long time, and yet it flew by. I think for the troll and the others, I was probably only gone a few minutes.
Oh, really?
A great team. I didn't read all of the books. Once I got started, many of the books remembered their texts.
Yeah.
It was as if they were awakening from a long sleep. I only had to read a few sentences, and they were able to remember who they were again.
Oh, okay.
The text came back, black as coal and crisp, and they began to quote from their contents, all at once. It was fantastic.
Here I thought you read them all.
Hello, friends.
He who from the world retires, void of hate is blessed. Who a friend's true love inspires, leaning on his breast.
Ah, very nice.
Wilbur, friend of books, has returned. Hail to our king.
Come on, I didn't do that much.
It is a kingly act to assist the fallen.
You seem to all be doing well again.
Well, at least someone likes them.
We have so many stories to tell, so much knowledge to share.
Tomorrow, I'll bring my students here. They could use a few good books.
And we could use them.
So the library has reappeared.
At last, the door to the library has reappeared. Things are going to get a lot livelier around here.
Oh, let's hope so. We don't want the library to be so ashamed of us that it hides again.
Is that why it disappeared?
It was ashamed?
Philosophy books that cannae hold a thought. Dictionaries almost speechless. Travel books that have lost their way. We were not a collection one could be proud of.
But what do you need the students for?
You said earlier that you need the students. What for?
You experienced it yourself. Books that are no longer read lose their power, fade, they're forgotten. Our ideas and our knowledge only stay alive for as long as we're read.
Hmm. Are all books actually alive, just like you?
Are all you books alive, then?
No. Even here, there are books that cannot emanate magic. Some books stay dead, no matter how often you read them.
Hmm.
Oh, I had a math book in school once. It was just like that.
Mm-hmm. I can imagine.
I've got to go. Lots to do. Ta-da.
Goodbye, Wilbur. And take time for a good book.
Hmm.
Whatever.
Whatever.
The books are right. Even the best book. The books have been through a lot. They deserve some rest.
Look at this book.
What is this? Laws of Aventasia.
Hmm.
Hello. Are you alive? You're not going to bite my finger off if I open you, right? In Bracken, men are forbidden by law from giving their wives a nasty look on Sundays.
Hmm.
In Belzine, women are forbidden to wear fake moustaches if said wearing could incite temple visitors to laughter.
Hmm.
Strange laws.
Yeah, really? Is that a reference to something?
What else have our legislators come up with? In Shindula, men and women over 18 years are prohibited by law from opening their mouths while smiling if doing so would reveal more than one missing tooth.
Hmm.
Oh, come on. No one could really come up with this stuff. These are the silliest laws I've ever heard of. In Seastone, public employees under 1.5 meters in height are not allowed to work at heights of more than 3 meters. Ah, I take it all back. This book is coming with me.
Oh, we got the book.
A law book full of crazy laws. One of them says that vertically challenged government employees cannot be forced to work at heights. I like that one. Could be helpful.
Hmm. There's a book here.
From the spirits that I call, sir, deliver me.
Aha! A suitable book, The Sorcerer's Apprentice.
Hmm.
Tell me, how did the apprentice get rid of the enchanted broom in the book again?
Back now, broom, into the closet. Be thou as thou wert before, until I, the real master, call thee forth to serve once more.
Hmm. Back now, broom, into the closet, be thou...
Hmm. Are we gonna need to know that? Let's talk to this time-traveling book.
Hello?
Wilbur, I've been waiting for you for a long time.
Time is, you know, subjective. Who are you?
Who are you?
Call me Emmett. Emmett, the Book of Time Travel.
Alternative, Emma, the scatterbrain.
I know everything there is to know about time travel.
Captain Nate traveled back in time. He had an amulet from the Archmage.
But our bewildered friend here thinks you can just zip around the time screen without the use of any magic at all. Just into the past. The future isn't written yet.
Sure.
Have you never heard of the word paradox? Eh?
If it were possible, we could save those poor books from being soaked through.
Right. So you were waiting for me?
You said you've been waiting for me.
Of course, for many years, since way back then.
But I don't think I've ever seen you before.
You didn't.
Of course you have. Many years in the past. It just hasn't happened yet. Hmm.
So how is time travel possible then?
Time travel without magic, I mean.
Why? How all journeys with books work. You read about a time, imagine it, and then, great Scott, you're there.
Just like that?
Hey presto, tra-la-la. It's that simple.
Precisely. If it didn't work, I wouldn't be telling you about it.
I'd like to try it. I want to travel into the past.
It can't hurt to try. Send me to the past.
I'm gonna need something.
Are you absolutely certain? The past is a strange place.
Tell me about it.
Well, listen.
Okay.
And the world was the same, and yet different.
What?